Hello gorgeous and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a video that the foodies are going to love. It's my absolute favorite current go-to lunch ideas. Really, I have been trying to get a little bit more creative with my lunch ideas so I can switch it up. I've also been bringing my lunch to work, which has been saving me a ton. As well as health-wise, it just more closely aligns with my fitness goals. So I'm also gonna be showcasing and sharing like my storage containers, how I pack my lunch, along with my super cute lunchbox. I have to show it. all these items are actually from Fit and Fresh, so I'll leave their link directly below. But yes, I love this lunch bag because it's like super insulated, it's huge, like spacious, and it has an ice pack that you can take in and out, and I don't know, it's just like super cute. Is it like not? It looks like a purse. Anyways, let's get right into these delicious recipes. Okay, so first up, I have my Mahi Mahi sauteed greens and sweet potatoes. And I start off with using 3 organic sweet potatoes that I got from Trader Joe's. I wash those and then I peel those, which peeling is completely optional. After they're peeled, I then like to cut them. I cut them into smaller pieces, but again, use the desired size that you would like. I just find that these are the perfect size to bake. And then once they're all cut, I take an 11 by 13 pan and I spray that with some spraying oil. And then I pour my 3 sweet potatoes in there and I take some extra virgin olive oil and pour that over lightly, and then take some sea salt and thyme and also sprinkle that over before I bake this on 350 heat for 25 minutes. So while that's cooking, I'm gonna go ahead and prepare the seasonings for my Mahi Mahi. I'm chopping an onion as well as mincing some fresh garlic, and then I pour that over like so before adding my already made seasonings. And I'm taking some garlic powder, black pepper, some lemon pepper, and then I'm also gonna be taking some thyme. I then take half of a lemon and squeeze that to pour the juice over the Mahi Mahi. Once it's all seasoned, I go ahead and I'm gonna cook this on stovetop heat. So I take my cast iron skillet, I spray that with oil, and then place my Mahi Mahi in there. And I like to cook these for 4 to 5 minutes on each side before flipping them over. So now that our protein's done, it's on to our vegetables and greens. I go ahead and I take another skillet and I just put some olive oil in there and some garlic powder, and I take some fresh mixed greens and saute those over medium heat. And there you have the finished product. Delicious. So now on to our fall salad. Okay, so for my protein, I'm actually going to be using garbanzo beans or chickpeas. This salad is completely vegan. So while that's cooking, I'm gonna go ahead and prepare my salad, and these are all of the ingredients. Don't worry, everything will be listed below, but I start off with some fresh kale, and then I core 1 green apple and 1 red apple. I cut them up into smaller pieces, but I'm actually, per salad, I'm only using half of a red and half of a green. So it's really 1 apple per serving, if that makes sense. I usually use both dried cranberries as well as the organic fresh cranberries. But for today's purpose, to lower the sugar intake, I'm only going to be using the organic cranberries. And I just pour that all in there. And I also add some snap peas for more protein as well as almonds. For my salad dressing, I like to make it. This has been a game changer. I basically pour some apple cider vinegar in there along with some olive oil as well as some pomegranate powder that I got from Target, and I just mix that all together in my Ninja, and this is the perfect, I mean the perfect taste of a salad dressing. I will not go back to store-bought salad dressings. So now I'm using my favorite Fit and Fresh container, and this is perfect for salads, and I just place my salads in there like so. And I love this mainly because the top has a cute little dispenser that you can actually pour your salad dressing to carry it separate. And you can also put cheese or whatever you would like in this in there. And I love the top as well because it has the little section for the ice pack that you can pop in and out. And this just keeps my salad perfectly fresh And for the chickpeas, I'm gonna pack that separate because I'm gonna heat them up in my smaller Fit and Fresh container. And that's just 1 cup. I love that it measures it out. And then I have lunch for today, tomorrow, and for whenever. On to my stir fry. I love this. I use organic brown rice with quinoa spaghetti. I love this because it's higher in protein. This is also another vegan meal. So I'm showing you all of the ingredients I use. But again, I'm using beefless ground beef and tofu because this is vegan, but you can substitute this with real meat if you use meat or with seafood, anything you would like. The important thing to remember when cooking tofu or beefless items is to basically cook it like you would meat. Again, all of the ingredients are gonna be listed below, but I like to season my tofu before I add the vegetables. The vegetables go on last, and then I basically add that into a larger pan and then pour the spaghetti in it and mix it all together. But if you're not vegan, I do suggest putting an egg in it, which I'll show, but just make sure when you are doing the egg that you do it with the meat before you even add the vegetables. And then you have a super healthy and delicious, completely vegan meal. Thank you so much for watching. And if you made it to the end, you might as well go ahead and click that subscribe link. That way you know whenever I post another video. Anyways, if you do decide to make one of these recipes, please let me know how it goes. I would love, love, love to know, as well as feel free to tag me on social media if you try any of these out. Anyways, I hope you guys have an amazing week. Do not forget to spread your light. God bless always. Deuces.